is Catherine. I have 4 kids. Isaiah is 13, Caleb is 8, Karina is 6, and Cameron is 2. I'm married to Jordan, who we've been together since I was 15 years old, and we've been married for about 10 years. When I was asked to talk about the work of a mother and to do a video in my house, I wanted to say no, because it's kind of scary. Because it just feels like chaos all the time, you know, 4 kids and a little house and a life and a job and all this stuff. It just feels like a lot. But when I thought about it, and when I think about what motherhood is to me, few words come to mind. One would be like enormous, overwhelming, and chaos. To be their mom is to be like all of the good things in their life, you know, like to love them and to protect them and take care of them. And in order to do that, it takes everything of me. It takes all my physical body to do all the things like a newborn, or it takes my mind when I'm trying to think about the right way to take care of them, and it takes my soul and my spirit as I pray for them and try to lead them in faith, which was not something I was raised with, so how do I do that? I don't really know. And because it requires everything, it pretty quickly feels like it's too much, and it's just really overwhelming sometimes. And it can feel really inadequate, and like I can't do all the things I want to do, and it's easy to go to bed every night feeling like I messed up again, and the thing I was gonna do, I didn't do, I should have said this, and I shouldn't have done that, and I can just really feel like failing all the time. And I think because it requires all of me, it requires a lot of grace. I hope he's not gonna be happy, I'm sorry. And so because it's a calling that requires all of me and all of who I am, and the stakes are so high, you know, taking care of kids and raising them up and knowing they're going to be adults and go out into the world, I have to live in grace. I have to live every day knowing that where I end, God has to make up the difference between that and what He wants for my kids' life and my own life. And the only way to do that for me is to stay as close to Him as I can. He has equipped me with everything that I need to take care of my kids and to raise them up. He's given me an amazing husband, and who is just like such a great father to them. He's given me the Spirit who lives in me, who helps me teach them and helps me to be kind when I don't want to be or whatever. Like he gives me everything I need, but I can't do anything without Him equipping me and giving me what I need. And so I have to live in a steady state of grace, because when I really consider essentially what is my call as a mom, it's to be Christ-like to my kids. It's to show them Jesus' love every minute, every day, in what I do. And that calling is really big, and really, it can really seem like too much. And I can only do it when I'm closely connected to Him, allowing His love to just go straight into me and out to them. Although the calling is so great and it feels too much at times, the Lord gives us what He needs, and then He gives us extra. You know, there was a service by Jonathan recently, and he talked about the quail, and that's what God does. Not just that I get to be with them and take care of them, I also get blessed so much by them. I mean, their love for me is just so beautiful. You know, they're little gifts to mommy, and I love you so much, and mom, you're the best. And this morning, you know, being able to talk with my teenager before he goes to school, it's just all so good. And it helps me keep going every day by the love that God shows me back through my kids.